Hi everyone, in this video we are going to see how to draw the development of a tourniqueted pentagonal prism. So tourniqueted implies it is sliced or cut by a sectional plane. So in that condition we are not dealing with a complete solid, we are dealing with a solid which is cut by a sectional plane. So this is the orthographic use which are given by us. We have to draw the development of this figure. So the sides are, the side of this tourniqueted pentagonal prism are, base is having 30 and this side is having 30 and the height is, the total height of the axis is 60. These are the dimensions given to us. So with this dimensions we are going to draw the development. First we are going to draw the same orthographic views, then we are going to draw the development here. So let's start. First of all, draw a horizontal line of a convenient length, then try to draw a line here, keep a little bit gap so that you can draw the solid pentagonal base of the pentagonal pyramid or tourniqueted pentagonal pyramid perpendicular, one of the base edges perpendicular to the vertical plane. So remember, whenever we are drawing development we will be imagining the solids perpendicular to horizontal plane only for our convenience. Okay, so now from these points you have to mark 108 degrees on both sides because the interior angle of a regular pentagon is 108 degrees. 0, 90, 100, 110, so this is your 108 on this side, from here also. So we are keeping here. So we have to be watching from here. 0, 90, 110, and 108. Right. Take your scale and draw a line equal to a length of 30 mm. On both sides. Right. From here also 108 degrees from this point. This is 108 here. Again 30 mm line. Right. We have completed the front view, top view. Then afterwards we will be drawing the front view from it. This is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Project these points onto this XY line. So these two points will be coming here itself. This is 1 dash and 5 dash, and 2 dash and 4 dash will be joining here. This is 2 dash and 4 dash, and this is 3 dash. Now draw a length of 30 mm line on this side and a 60 mm line on this side as given in the figure. Now join these two edges, that gives them front view of the orthographic view which is required. Now project these points here. So this is here will be 1 and 5 and this will be 3 here. Now project 2 dash and 4 dash also. So this is your 2 and 4. Right, extend this line to a length of 30 into how many sides? 5. That is equal to 150 mm. That is, you have to draw a length of 15 mm. Choose a point here so that you have to draw a length of 15 cm. 150 mm is 15 cm. Now complete it to a height of 60 mm as the axis height or complete height of the solid is 60 mm. Now join these two ends. Now you have to divide the base into equal number of parts, so that is 30 mm each. As there is a pentagon, you have to divide it into 5 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is first part, second part, third part, fourth part and fifth part. Draw vertical lines as this is the prism. So draw faint lines first, then we can highlight later. Okay, now project the points. These from this points also you have to draw horizontal lines, but very faint. Okay, now after that you have to join the line here also, small one, right? Now give the naming, numbering as per your requirement. You can draw start from 4, 3, 2, whatever it is. So I am taking the numbering as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1 will be repeating again. So the starting point, this is the point where we are cutting. So 1 will be repeating at the other end also. Okay, right, just we have to point the intersection points. So 1 and this is 1. So your point is, this is your 1. And this is your 5 and this is your 5. So this point is your 5. Now this is your 2 and this is your 2. So this point is your 2. Next 4 is come here and this is 4. And this is your 3 and this is the 3. Right, now take your scale and join them with straight lines. As this is a prism, if you cut, you will be seeing a straight edges, not curved edges. If you cut, if you tourniquet any cylinder or cone, you have to join with a smooth hand, a free hand, because cone and cylinder will be having smooth cutting edges, curved cutting edges. Draw them darkly. Okay, now highlight the bottom portions also. So the darkened portion is the part we required, and the rest portion, this portion is not required, which is been sectioned and removed. Okay, so this portion, this curved portion, that is the part we required. If you fold it, it will be forming into this tourniqueted pentagonal prism. Okay, so that is how we draw the development of a tourniqueted objects. So in later videos we'll be seeing how to draw the tourniqueted cylinder and tourniqueted cone also, and we'll be seeing tourniqueted pyramids also. So that's it. And you can mark the dimensions here, that is 30, this is 30, and this side you can mention here itself 60, and this length is 150. So thank you.